Hi, I'm Bill Corcoran Jr., and I'm your host for the On the Stacks podcast. Today, I'm chatting with Glenn Lawless, National Accounts Dealer Development Manager at InterMetro Industries. What's up, podcast? Episode 25. Welcome to the On the Stacks podcast, Glenn. How are you?
I am amazing, my man.
Thank you.
I'm feeling good.
Yeah. And you brought these green beers.
Green beers. Great beers.
Great beers. Sorry, yes. I meant to say great, not green. Oh, I did actually mean to say green. It's got this crazy green goblin on it.
Oh, yeah, he does. He does. This is good stuff.
Yeah. So you brought some really cool props.
Yes, yes. Well, I didn't want to let you down, Bill.
I'm highly impressed. And we'll talk about some of those in a minute. But before we get into Metro and the Mighty Light.
Yes.
I got it right this time.
Yeah, you did. There you go.
And the beers in there and everything else and the cart.
Yes.
It's not called a cart.
It's called a MyFold.
Okay.
Yeah, everything's my.
My, okay. So tell me a little bit about your background. You worked at Metro at one point and
yes.
then you left and now you're back, but you've also worked a couple other places
before that.
And in between. You started your career, I think, in the marketing for,
Financial services.
Yeah.
So I was going to Kutztown University and majoring in business there. And I had an opportunity to, I interned at Prudential Retirement. Many years ago, and it was right after actually September 11th. Like that's when, like, and you know, I kind of remember being nervous about walking into there because a lot of people just, you know, they're in the financial industry, the economic markets, you know, they took a hit. So I went in there, but I guess I must have done something nice because they asked me to come back. They asked me to come back full time
After your internship.
After the internship, yeah. So I didn't want to go there. I actually didn't want to work in the financial industry full time. I was like, I don't know. I want to, you know, I want to throw paint against the walls. I want to do something fun in marketing, you know.
Yeah.
You know? I started working there, and you know, after a couple of years, it turned into eight. So I worked there for 8 years. But the cool thing was, I made my intentions known earlier that I wanted to work in marketing. Like I just start meeting people, and eventually I got into a really fun marketing role where. I guess
there,
yes. Mm-hmm. And it's kind of funny, but I used to have to create pamphlets and brochures about like asset allocation and, hey, Bill, don't eat or don't drink that latte, that expensive latte, because you could take that money and put it into a retirement
$5
plan.
$5 a day.
That's right. And you could have the magic of compound interest. So that was my world for a while. And
sounds fun.
Oh my God. It was amazingly fun. So, then all of a sudden, right, trying to tell people how to live the retirement dream in 2009, 2008 hit, which if you guys remember what happened in 2008, 2009, mm-hmm. the financial markets crashed, layoffs, especially in the financial world, were happening. And here's the thing. I just proposed to my girlfriend, just got engaged. I just moved in with her. We got a dog. We got like all this stuff. I mean, you've done this recently, all this stuff. So we were about to get married in the fall. And they laid me off. There was, you know, the priority, and unfortunately, I was let go. So it was very tough. And a friend of mine said, "Hey, Glenn, there's this great company locally called Metro. If you want to work, you know, I'm sure I can put in a good word and maybe get an interview there." So I started an interview, and I worked there for 2 years. And for people who don't know, Metro is a storage and equipment company, storage and transport equipment company. Basically, you know, I worked in the food service industry, and that's kind of the market that we're geared toward. But I started working there for 2 years, and I was there, and then you know, I learned a lot of great stuff. People, I mean, I couldn't believe how smart people were when I started working there. That's what got me. And again, I just came out of getting my MBA, which, by the way, Prudential paid for, which was very interesting. And then that happened. But the Metro, like I went there, and I just couldn't believe how smart everyone was. I feel like I was doing like an MBA case study like every day. It was just, I couldn't believe it. But then ended up getting a role. Someone randomly reached out to me and asked me like, "Hey Glenn, would you be interested in a role at the casino?" And I had a really good friend of mine who reached out, and I remember going with him to the casino during, like, have you ever been up at the casino when they had like events outside by the racetrack?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Well, they had like a Michael Jackson, tribute band, and they had fireworks going off that night too. Well, I remember going with my friend who invited me there, And they were having issues like behind the scenes where like people, crowds were like stepping on like the wires that set off the fireworks. And I remember this person saying to me, like one of my friends saying, Glenn, can you just like have those people direct those people over there? Like, so they're not stepping on. And I remember like kind of stepping in and being like, yeah, sure. And like telling these people like, hey, don't sit on there or don't move there. Like the fireworks are going to go off later. Anyway, long story short is, I kind of was like, wow, it must be a neat place to work. Well, he asked me, my friend of mine, he said, he was actually the head of operations there. He invited me in for a role. It was called Director of Guest Relations. And I don't know, I started working there. And, you know, I mean, the casino industry was the hospitality industry in general was just, it was a different world, especially what I, you know, working in the financial industry. The cool thing about working at the casino was there was hospitality, like you're in the hospitality industry, right? But then I kind of got that from working at Metro a little bit, because in the food service industry, selling food service equipment, you know, you kind of feel that energy, right? And delivering to the customer. So the role that I was asked to do was, it was Director of Guest Relations. And you probably heard this before, I told you, but I jokingly called myself the Chief Apology Officer there.
Oh yes, I remember
yeah,
that.
Yes, yeah. Because,
so why?
Oh my God, because I said, I'm sorry. That was my role. I said, I'm sorry. We worked at a proactive guest recovery, sort of the head cheerleader there too for like guest service and just, you know, trying to inspire people, motivate people. And it was a really fun role. You know, I learned a lot of things about, just, you know, customer service in general, how to treat a customer, all those things really, you know, kind of resonated with me. But I will say it's definitely fun. It was a very fun work, but it was very hard to leave Metro to go there, I gotta say.
I learned a lot
and have some crazy stories. This is nuts, and I'll tell this story. There was, besides all the, you know, the amazing things that I learned there, and I had great mentors and lots of people there.
And we're still talking about the casino, right?
We're talking about the casino, okay, yeah. One time there was this girl who called in who, you know, she wanted a discount on her play, right? She wanted more free play, if you will. And I told her I couldn't do that based off your play level. Well, unfortunately, she kind of, you know, she rebutted and she said, Glenn, she's like, like, do you understand what I do for the casino? And I said, what do you mean, what do you do for the casino? She said, well, and I couldn't tell initially, but she did let me know that she said, I'm a transgender. And I said, okay, all right, that's great. She goes, well, Glenn, I provide a certain type of, you know, entertainment that people can't provide here. And I was like, excuse me? She goes, Glenn, I used to be a guy. And she goes, I provide you know, men are always looking for strange. And I was aghast. I was appalled. I couldn't believe she said that to me. So this girl was literally trying to get free play off of me because of the level of entertainment she said she provided. So it was, anyway, it was crazy. I'll say that. So that is like one of the craziest things that's happened to me besides, you know, I will say there was a lot of fun times during, the times when, you know, Will Beekman was on last time and he talked about, you know, having the availability of seeing the shows and just being a part of the energy. And that was great and fun, but it's true. When you're in that world, you don't really get to see it and experience it the way that the
from
customer
the,
does.
From the other side.
Exactly.
So yeah. you're running the show.
Not running the show, but you're definitely working it. There's a lot of people behind you that help do it. So yeah. But yeah, the biggest thing I can take away from there is just the focus on the customer and what they're going through at the time. So then, another crazy thing that happened there was, and if I could take a flying DeLorean back in time, I would take it back, and you guys might have heard about, there was an embezzlement scandal there.
Uh-huh,
at the casino, yeah. And unfortunately, someone embezzled over $500,000 at the casino, and it totally rocked the entire management there. And I would say probably, I don't know, a majority, just everything, you know, the cascading effects from that. If I go back in time and tell that person like, hey, what you're about to do is going to change the whole landscape. But, yeah, so unfortunately, you know, one day I got a call or unfortunately I got a call and was told that, in 2017 that, you know, your job is no longer required here. And, I found out that 7-10 other people got let go that day too. So
basically because of that embezzlement scheme, know, the casino was hurting and had to let some people go.
It wasn't that. It was they just needed a shakeup in management. It was one of those. Like, you literally felt like you were in a mob movie. Like, people were looking at, like, you were looking over your shoulder because people were just getting let go, or their positions were being changed out. And it was an interesting time. But then that happened. And literally that day that the article came out, I got a call. And by the way, my wife just decided, again, it's another thing. My wife just decided to stay home because with our child. I have two children at home. And at the time I had one. So
she became stay-at-home mom and you lost your
job. Stay-at-home mom and I lost my job a month later.
Good timing.
Oh my gosh. You know what they say? What do they say? You want to make God laugh, make plans. Mm-hmm. Well, that was our plan. And, you know, something crazy happened. So literally the day that the article came out about, you know, a lot of leadership positions being let go, I got a call from someone at Metro. And they said, Glenn, I just read this article. Like, were you caught up in this? I said, I did not, you know, I wasn't caught up in some of the other things they were talking about previously. And again, this is like a year later after a lot of that stuff got brought to light. But I said, I was part of that. And they said, listen, you know, we really enjoyed what you did at Metro. Why don't you come on back and interview? I think there might be a position available. So I got to come back to Metro. And, you know, I call it Metro 2.0. Because it was the same company I loved, but it was definitely a different company. You could just feel it. There was, you know, new leadership, just a new direction. There was a focus back on some of the things that, you know, I was part of previously. So it just felt good overall.
Yeah. So what exactly is Metro?
Metro, or InterMetro Industries, it was actually founded back in 1929 in New York City. And in 19, I think it was 57, it was brought here, to Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania. The headquarters actually here in Pennsylvania. We're a global company. We, operate in different markets: commercial, healthcare, food service. And, what we do is we help, food service operators, we help them become more efficient. We optimize. Like you saw, I had that MyFold, you know, that cart, you know, things like that. Our better bread and butter, a lot of people know us by, is we're the original patent creators of the wire shelf. If anyone here has ever worked in like the, you know, the back of house or a kitchen or a server, you've seen the wire shelves. We're the original patent creator.
Do you guys still do that?
We do. It's right. It's a big part of what we do. We still sell, it's called Super Recta. We definitely have innovated the products since then. It's really neat to be able to work for a company that is, you know, a global company that's headquartered out of Wilkes-Barre, Pennsylvania. So this
is the true headquarters.
This is the true headquarters.
And it's only like two blocks from here.
That's right. I got to say, literally, this is the easiest drive I ever taken. Like, I was looking at my watch going, oh, all right, tell me, literally, you're a 3-minute drive away.
That's it.
And I've never been here. That's what's crazy. That's what's crazy about it.
But you probably pass by it all the time.
I know. I pass by it all the time. I'm glad I know where the podcast studio is now. So it's great.
Yeah. So next time you drive by, I mean, you see the windows. You see we're at the corner here. You can beep and wave.
I'm totally going to beep. Especially at 5:30.
Mike Mann is saying no.
Thursday.
Yeah. When we typically record. And, you know, so then we, you know, it interrupts the podcast because we're not too soundproof here.
Oh, yeah. No, I like it. I like it.
But you should beep.
Yes.
Sirens are going off right now.
No, that's good. It's good. I like it.
Hope everything's okay out there.
Things are fine, people. Yeah, no worries.
Everything's okay. You brought some really cool props. Again, I'm highly impressed by the props.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Like I said, I didn't want to let you down, Bill. Did not want to let you down.
I mean, I feel unconquerable with this. It's called the Metro Masher.
Oh, yes.
And I'm picking it up right now.
Yeah.
But yes, I feel unconquerable with this thing.
Wow, that is a good word.
You like that word?
That is a very good
unconquerable
word.
Unconquerable.
Man, you just...
How'd I do?
That's like a 50-cent word, a dollar word, I don't even know.
Yeah, Mike Mann's giving the thumbs up.
Good.
So I had to use the word unconquerable in a sentence.
No, that's a pretty impressive... I gotta say, we have talented people. We have creative people at Metro. And actually, the day that video was made, before that, like one of our own creative guys, he's one of our designers, multimedia guys.
What's his name?
His name's Brett. And Brett actually, he
So Brett was the guy in, he was the guy smashing the
He wasn't the
food.
Guy. No, that was actually AJ Zambetti, he's our creative director. He's AJ and
Yo, AJ, if you're listening, you you threw that Metro Masher like a boss.
Oh, he's like the new Gallagher reincarnated. So, not that we're copywriting anything, you know.
Yeah, so tell me the story. So, you know, for those that are listening, probably have no idea what we're talking about right now, but no. Glenn brought this like 4 foot tall Thor-like
Mjolnir. You gotta say it.
Mjolnir.
You don't know it. Yeah, Bill Mjolnir. Didn't know what Mjolnir was. Yeah. I'm gonna call him out right now.
I did. So Glenn texted. I asked him to bring the. I don't know what did I call it in the text to you?
You just said the hammer, the smasher. Called the Metro.
I call it the Metro Masher. Yeah, because that's what it says on the side. So I text Glenn earlier. I said, "Yo, can you bring the Metro Masher?" And you're like, "Oh my god, let me make a phone call." And then you sent. And then like you apparently got it. You got a hold of it. You sent me a photo of it. And then in your text with the photo, you just said what? You just said one word.
Mjolnir. Come on. Everyone out there in podcast land knows what Mjolnir is. Come on.
Yeah. So I'm not good with big words or Mjolnirs.
But that thing that you are wielding right now with authority, may I say.
Yeah. Unconquerable.
Unconquerable authority. You know, like that's sort of the when I said Metro 2.0, that's sort of the what I like about being back at Metro is that, you know, there's certain things that I feel like we, you know, maybe didn't do in the past, but I feel like, you know, we know that we got to innovate and we got to, you know, go in certain places creatively, you know, take some risk here and there. And, you know, we're doing things different than a lot of our industry are doing. You know, a lot of people think, you work in B2B. So, you know, like you've seen a lot of the glossy print ads and that's it, you know.
It's hard to get creative and, you know, do different things and. You know, this Metro Masher, I mean, back to the video.
Yeah.
So you guys made this video.
Yeah.
And AJ. Wielded. This Metro
like
Masher like a boss.
Yes.
And smashed multiple pieces of food.
Yes.
Including a watermelon on top of your, what was it?
Super Erecta Pro.
Say it again.
Super Erecta Pro. That's right. It's the.
I don't know why I'm laughing. I do know why I'm laughing.
It is. You know, it's
interesting word.
It is the new standard. As we say in walk-in cooler shelving. So if you guys ever walked in a restaurant, we are like that's there.
You'll see Super Erecta Pros.
Well, you're gonna see just Super Erecta. You know, epoxy coated shelving. Typically, walk-in shelving. Everyone who works in the industry, they know what it is. But this is what should be in there because it's protection.
So you guys made this awesome video, by the way. It's on I think I saw it on your LinkedIn page, on Metro's LinkedIn page, but you guys made this awesome video, you know, showing the durability and the strength and how great the product is.
Yep. And so here's the thing. It's a product that we want to help people. We don't want people to just do the things that they always done, right? What's the quote? If you always do what you always done, you always get what you always got. And it's the definition of insanity.
Yeah.
We want them to realize that there's a better thing out there. Why are you shoveling with a spoon when you could be using a bulldozer, you know? So this is what, that product that I showed you, like it cleans well, it's durable. So those are the things that we're trying to just let, you know, get people's attention. And if it's smashing a watermelon, that's going to do it.
Oh my God.
That's what it's going to do.
That was the coolest video ever.
The same thing with the Mighty Light. You probably haven't seen it on LinkedIn, but that thing, you know what we've done with that? Again, this is kind of where I saw like the sort of the new creative risk we're doing. We literally blow that up with a mortar firework.
I think I may have seen it. Was there a video?
Yeah, there was a video.
I think we blow it up
with a firework. We hit it with a Metro truck, which by the way, it cracked the windshield. I don't know if everyone knows that in podcast land, but
wow.
The thing's indestructible, the Mighty Light. We throw it off a roof. You probably saw me from up here, probably doing that down here.
We can throw it off the roof today if you want.
Let's do it.
We might have to.
Here we go. I know.
Yeah. Or I can take the Metro Masher and try to smash it.
You know
it.
What? Do you think? That would actually, you know what? Let's do that. I'm down with it. Let's go. You know what? That stuff is actually made out of the same stuff your car bumper is made out of.
Interesting.
That's why we can do that kind of stuff with it. So okay.
Very cool.
Yeah.
So what is it exactly that you do?
So what do I do? I guess I never said that. Really.
Yeah. I've seen you in a couple of videos.
Yeah. So
like you were kind of like a stand-in or something.
Yeah. You know, the guy in the background. which by the way, I do not mind being the guy in the background. And you know what? That's why I appreciate shelving so much. I mean, it's one of those things, if you think about it, it's like if you think of the food service operator world and like the restaurants, it's like a fire, right? There's always something going on. Like the shelving is the first one in and it's the last one out. right? It's kind of humble. It's a humble hero, I'll say. But anyway, my job is, I used to be in the marketing realm primarily. And basically, you know, marketing, the marketing world, preparing for shows, helping to market our dealers, gain awareness of our products, you know, and our big focus was digital. Our big focus was doing things through video. So that was a big part of what I was doing. And then last year, actually, over the summer, I stepped into a new role closer to sales, got to travel a little bit more with our national accounts and work with and be an account manager for them. So the funny thing is, and I said this, so today, and my role, by the way, is it's National Account Dealer Development Manager.
Yeah, it's a really long title. It's like
National Account Dealer Development Manager.
Yeah, it's like a tongue twister.
That's why I just say I work at Metro, right?
Yeah, okay.
You know, the interesting thing is, like today was actually the first day that I actually was actually back at the office. And I got to say, I feel like a wild animal out in the wild. I haven't really gone out so much. Like I said, today was the first day I think I put on like long socks, like to come here.
Well, I'm glad I can be part of your...
Oh my God, that's probably why I prepped so much.
You did.
Yeah, I know.
That's well, and thankfully...
It was like a big deal.
And thankfully, you had the time to round up all these props.
Oh yeah, that's right.
I mean, because, you know, I mean, you've seen some of the other props and there's been, you know, some...
Well, cool, you're literally cool. next door, so yeah. I had no excuse.
I had
no excuse. And I was like, you know, I meant to drop by.
Yeah.
But I was saying with the whole COVID thing, like,
What was the shirt?
Oh yes,
the disrupted 2020.
Right.
Is that where you
that's
were gonna?
Right. Yeah, that's where I was going. So literally, I was, you know, travel a little bit. We Metro, and I like to think like we're ahead of the curve, right? And not to sound too arrogant and cocky, but you know we are. We put a lot of planning.
Yeah, you really are.
Into where we're going and a lot of focus. Again, a lot of smart people. I said, but we had a sales themed. Like global sales meeting, we called it down near Washington. And
when was it?
It was back in January, end of January.
Okay.
And we called it, the theme was, we called it Disruption 2020.
Wow. And that was like, you know, COVID really wasn't talked about then, just a little bit, because it was still in China at that point.
Exactly. You heard about it and like, it wasn't even a big deal then. It was just in China, it was isolated. And our focus then was, we were talking about what we need to do for 2020, where we need to be. And it was just things about, again, I'm not sharing any proprietary secrets, but it was like, basically like we need to be more digital. Like that was it. Like we need more digital. We need to be more educating and providing content and how are we partnering? And there's just a lot of things that I'm going to say this helped us now
to prepare for
a global pandemic
and work from home.
Yes.
You know,
I mean, all this stuff. And you know what, if it wasn't for, I think the foresight of some great leaders at Metro, like I'm just saying, I don't think we'd be in the position we are now. And
yeah.
Which is we're, you know, we're doing things to help provide value to, even though we can't visit and travel and like we used to, we're still providing valuable content and value to our customers.
Yeah. You guys definitely are. I follow you guys on LinkedIn. And if anyone's listening and wants to go to Metro's LinkedIn, you got to check it out. You'll see some really cool videos, hammer smashing of food, blowing up of
Mighty Lights. Yes,
hitting it with a truck.
Yes, all that kind of fun
stuff.
A lot
of cool stuff. But, you know, one other thing I want to talk about is you guys are a global company, but you're based here.
Yeah.
And, you know, how many people do you guys employ locally? Do you know the number?
Locally, I think, wow.
It's a lot.
I know at this building we have over 100, but we have several plants here in the Wilkes-Barre area. We have a distribution center. We have a factory, all in this area. But worldwide we employ over 1500 employees.
Okay.
But there's a lot of people here. I wish I knew the number, maybe in the show notes or something, we can put them in there,
yeah.
But I don't know, but I'll say this is
just
that
leave a comment on Facebook or Instagram after. How about that?
That's what I'll do.
All right. Hold me to it. And everyone's going to hear this and I'm not editing this part out.
But I will say this. One of the things I really appreciated about before I took my first time at Metro, my job, was I remember like just looking up Metro and Googling and searching. And one of the things I really appreciated was I found an article by our president and CEO, John Nackley. And he must have been interviewed for a book or an article. And he basically said how much meaning there is and purpose he finds in being able to strive and fight, you know, to do the things we have to do to make sure that we provide a meaningful, you know, and you know, wage for people and give them a you know, work life here in the Wilkes-Barre area. So that meant a lot to me when I saw that. And that's probably one of the reasons why I definitely came on board, because I saw that it made sense, you know.
Yeah.
And connecting it.
Yeah. How about the kitchen makeover contest?
Yeah. So, you know, speaking of, and that's a good segue, speaking of purpose like and why. So, you know, we do something every year. I think it's the third year we're doing it. We do something called the Kitchen Storage Makeover Contest. And, you know, we have another big partner that helps us with it, promote it. And what we do is we basically give over $50,000 in food service equipment, on metro equipment, to, you know, an operator. So we ask for submissions every year and people turn in, and you should see some of these places. I mean,
so who can enter?
Who can enter? Any operator, actually.
So like small business restaurants?
Small business restaurants, schools, you name it.
Healthcare hospitals.
Healthcare hospital. If you have a kitchen.
What about my kitchen at home?
No, not your kitchen. Even though, I mean, I don't know. Does it need some work? Does it need some help?
Not really, but no. I mean, it could use a mighty light.
Oh, you know what? Okay. All right. I see what you did there, yeah. Bill. Okay. We'll see. I might know a guy, you know.
So the contest.
Yeah. So the contest, basically we reach out to, you know, submit your videos, and people, you know, send us this stuff that we want to help everyone. That's the hard part. You start to see like how, I don't even know how people get through like their operations every day. But one of the things that I appreciate about it is we got to go in the first year and I got to help build equipment and put it into a kitchen. And I mean, like just putting in rolling equipment and in the walk-in and stuff like that, you get to see, you just get to see the smile on employees' faces. Like, you don't realize it. And here's the thing.
How much easier it makes their life.
Oh, my God. And when I worked at the casino, I got to see that firsthand, because I used to go in all the departments, whether you're in table games, whether you're in the hotel side, whether you're in on the racetrack. I would just ask, like, hey, if you could wave a magic wand, like, what would you want? You know? And I swear to God, all of them said they want more space. And they just want a cart that doesn't fall over. They want a shelf that they can put things. Like, I was surprised.
Like basic stuff. And these people don't have it.
And they don't have it. So like I really, for me, doing that with the kitchen storage makeover and helping to put this equipment in, like, and seeing the smiles on their face, like, it provided a purpose for me and meaning behind it. So that's another great reason, you know, that I, working for Metro, I feel very close to the hospitality industry.
Yeah.
And being able to do that.
So is that contest going on right now?
You know what? The winner was actually just chosen.
Oh, okay.
The winner was chosen, and I think they're in Virginia Beach right now. I don't know the name of the winner. Because okay. Maybe it wasn't announced publicly at this time.
No spoilers here.
That's
no
right.
Spoilers.
No spoilers. No way. But it's our third year. It's very successful, and we're going to keep on doing it.
Really cool. So, but people can look out for it next year.
Yes, definitely.
And when does it start?
It starts around, I think, the fall. We start really like getting back into it.
Oh, okay. Well, then yeah, it's right coming up soon. Then
that's right.
Okay,
it's coming around the corner. We'll start promoting it early.
Really cool.
Things were a little delayed with COVID.
Yeah.
You know, the fact that we get down there. But again, we have a great team of people that are just that work on it. So
my beer's empty.
Uh-oh. What do you need?
I don't know. Should we dig into the Mighty Light?
Let's dig into the Mighty Light. Let's open it up.
We're going to take a timeout from the podcast to dig into the Mighty Light. All right. So we're back from the intermission.
Back from the intermission.
Part two. I've got my beer refilled. And... yeah, so we were just talking about the makeover contest, but how about, you know, you talked a little bit about the impact that Metro has here on NEPA, and I just want to talk a little bit about that quick. What is your favorite thing about NEPA?
Oh, my favorite thing about NEPA, not NEPA, by the way, not NEPA.
No, you clearly listened to the podcast.
Yeah, I've heard the podcast, and I'm like,
do you remember who that was?
I know I say NEPA.
You do?
I do, but you know what, though? But here's the deal. I'm not from NEPA.
Stop saying that.
I'm originally from Philly, and I moved up to Wyalusing.
Wait, you're originally from Philly?
I'm originally from Philly, man. Kensington.
Oh, I don't think I knew that.
Yeah, originally from Philly. Philly boy.
Oh.
Moved out when I was like 10, 11.
And you moved to NEPA?
Moved to... Well, technically, no. I moved to like near the Reading area, and then I moved to Wyalusing, which is like where people have... cabin. Every time I tell someone from Wyalusing, they're like, oh, I have a hunting cabin up there. You hunt, you fish. It's what you do.
But you lived there.
I lived there. It was great. I went to high school there.
Okay.
And,
you know, when I was in high school, I was a runner, and we used to run against them in some
like cross country,
yeah, cross country.
Oh yeah. They have a great cross country and track.
Well, no, they didn't. Not at the time. Not at my time. And, yeah. You know, I feel kind of like a jerk, but you know, every time we used to joke and call them, "Why you losing?"
Yeah, I've never heard that before. Yeah. Unfortunately, you know, it was either "Why you losing?" or we got confused with "Why you missing?"
Okay.
Which, yeah, by the way, that's where Taylor Swift's from. I heard you say that the other day.
Taylor Swift, yeah. Swiftie now. Me and Will are Swifties.
Oh man.
But so you're not from NEPA.
No, I'm not from NEPA. But my favorite thing about NEPA or NEPA, I'll say NEPA.
Well, if you say NEPA one more time, you're off the podcast. Mike, hit the record button. We're out.
My favorite thing is, so here's something that I've heard said before, but it's true. Like, being from down near Philly, there's a lot of roots and people think family is strong. But, you know, I've seen a lot of broken families in Philly. Like, I've seen just a lot of, like, what I think NEPA doesn't have.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I did that for you. That's
thank
all you.
You,
Bill.
Thank you.
It's the family environment here is something I've never seen before. Like, people truly, genuinely, like, you know, the way that they will drop everything for their family, I really appreciate that. And then number two, which I know I've heard before, is the pizza.
Yeah, you can't go wrong. It's not a bad answer.
And by the way, I think it's so funny, like, how competitive, how, like, you know, in the El Presidente in the area, like, all that stuff just blows my mind. I think it's awesome. I think that's probably why I married my wife. She used to work at Pizza Lovin'.
Oh my God.
Back in the day.
Some of the best pizza.
Square fried pizza. Oh my gosh. Like, oh, has a special place in my heart. Definitely.
I love the pizza. I love it. No, not a bad answer. I mean, pizza is...
Pizza. Family and pizza. Boom.
What else do you need?
NEPA in a nutshell?
That's it. Cut the show. It's over. It's over. I'm going to take the... Metro Masher and smash you with it if you say NEPA one more time.
I knew that would make you mad. I knew it. That's why I keep on saying it. Yeah. But anyway, but I'm not a native. But then again, have I gone native? I've been here 20 years now.
You are now. 20?
Yeah, basically.
Okay. Yeah, you're basically a native.
All right. I should start saying NEPA. All right.
No.
NEPA.
Yeah.
Sorry.
You've had too many IPAs.
Probably.
Yeah.
I think every podcast should have an IPA in the hand.
If you stock them. Or if they want to stock them. Glad to keep them in the Rebinac fridge over here.
Oh.
Shout out to Rebinac.
Wow.
Not an ad, but thankful for their donation to the podcast studio.
Wow. That's,
you know?
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. Previous guest.
Okay.
All right. He was like one of the first few guests on.
I got to say, I've heard about the table.
Yeah.
I've seen the fridge.
But you don't know the story? Well, you haven't listened to Jim Broda's.
No, I did.
Oh,
you did? I did listen about the... I did.
So did you miss the fact that, like, he gave me the fridge?
And so you're saying I should give you a Mighty Light? Is that what you're saying? Or a Mighty... Or
yes.
The Mighty Masher?
Yeah.
Metro Masher.
Everything you brought is now mine.
I own it all.
Yes. All mine. Okay. So you're basically an NEPA native now.
I am. I love it. It's so great here.
Yeah.
I love living here.
I've confirmed it.
You know what's cool? I remember I did a... what's it called? Leadership Wilkes-Barre. And that's where I had the opportunity to not only... meet Will Beekman, by the way, but I've also had the opportunity to meet tons of people. But that's when I kind of like understood this area. If it wasn't for Leadership Wilkes-Barre, I feel like I wouldn't appreciate it as much. So that's another shout out to Leadership Wilkes-Barre. There you go.
Nice.
But I just felt it was impactful because, like, of all the people I met there and how we still keep in touch, it's just a really great organization.
Really cool. So kind of to wrap things up here, how else can someone learn about InterMetro? Metro.com, your social media.
Yeah, just go online, go to Facebook, go to Instagram. I mean, I think the only thing we don't cover is TikTok. I mean, but we're probably next. Probably
Unless next. Unless Microsoft doesn't buy it and Trump bans it, then. Yeah.
But search for Metro Food Service or just Metro, InterMetro, and you should find all of our amazing things. We're blowing up stuff. And again, we have such a great team that builds amazing videos where things are blowing up
and we're
smashing watermelon.
And we're Glenn Stars in the background.
That's right. Just in the background.
Standing.
Anytime.
Standing guy.
Talent.
Yeah, you are. You are the talent of the background. All right. Well, Glenn Lawless, InterMetro Industries, On the Stacks podcast. Thanks for joining me today, Glenn.
Later. Thanks.
If you'd like to learn more about the On the Stacks podcast, be sure to search the hashtag On the Stacks on Instagram, Facebook, and LinkedIn. If you enjoyed this podcast, please subscribe and leave a review. We'll catch you next time on the Stacks.